Hello there, we're glad to have you here on The Big Q, and joining me in the studios is the Commissioner General for Rwanda Revenue Authority, Mr. Richard Tusabe. We are glad to have you on The Big Q.
Thank you.
Manwutera Mugabe wants to know, what is Rwanda Revenue's organization focus this financial year?
Wow, very interesting. The focus this year is mainly about widening the tax base. Widening the tax base in the sense that how do you increase the number of taxpayers? Yeah. But also how the other key focus is the compliance level of the people who are in the tax net. That's why if you see our campaigns, even these 2 months, we've been mainly focusing on the electronic billing machines, compliance on VAT. Mm. And as you try to improve compliance, also you need to focus on the enforcement part. So again, as a normal routine, we're going to focus on education to ensure that people actually comply and have voluntary compliance as opposed to forced compliance.
Another issue is Rwanda Revenue has always ensured to have convenient tax collection systems or payment systems in place. And Musime Ruranga says, why should I go through RRA agent to get a payment form charged 500 Rwandan francs for that service? Then after go to pay in the bank and the bank charges me again extra 500 Rwandan francs on every RRA payment I make. Then what is the importance of those agents if they can't receive money but rather charge us money?
You can declare the tax and pay directly using your bank account. So there is no middleman. If you go directly, you can pay using your bank account. But also, we've tried to have a bridge gap measure in terms of getting other people to come in as middlemen, if I may use the word. Mm. For example, the mobile money solutions.
Yes.
So what we are saying, if you have a mobile money account, why don't you declare and pay using your mobile money wallet? Of course, this is done by third parties like MTN, Tigo, and also MobiCash. So those people will charge a nominal fee, but we also need to appreciate the cost that they're charging. Let me take an example of the 500, maybe which you are going to be charged by MTN or Tigo or MobiCash.
Or even the cyber cafes.
Or the cyber cafe. If you compare that 500 francs to the time that you've been spending, it would take as long as 3 days for you to finalize the whole process, moving up and down with paperwork. So you also need to put these things into perspective. The cost of 500 vis-a-vis the time that you are spending in the queue, the paperwork, which also cost a lot more than 500, but compared to what you were paying before, I think it's a very big achievement. And we strongly believe that even that cost can come down as the people start using the service and appreciate the service.
Okay, Ejid Makbera comes in with a wonder why RRA is seen closing big businesses often. Why not 2 or 3 years back before we lost what those revenues should work for? Is that because of the pressure RRA got from PAC, and why wait for pressure from high levels to act?
Yes, let me first of all appreciate, I think that's a very good concern. Why now? I think we've been doing it in the recent past. Mm. And even the people that the business that you see us trying to close down, to close because they've not complied with their tax arrears, in the last couple of years we've been engaging them. And they've given us promises, which they've not managed to honor. So it's not a question of saying that because PAC has raised a red flag that the tax administration has some gaps in terms of tax collection that we've strongly enforced. It's a fact that we've been engaging these businesses, but not ruling out the good advice that we get from the PAC. Also, I think also that one we need to acknowledge that it has also given us another dimension of looking at our business. So to answer the question, I think it's not a question of PAC coming in. It's our normal routine that actually the laws allow us that if someone does not comply, you get into an amicable discussion, which we've gone through with these businesses. We've signed agreements of payment plans, which they've not respected. So you find yourself that you're not left with so many options other than actually closing the business. But our strategy and our theory is that we should not be closing business, we should actually be promoting business growth.
Mm.
Otherwise, if I close the business, who is going to pay the taxes tomorrow?
No.
So it's not our, it's a last resort that we have to get to, but again, the few businesses that we've tried to close, I think some of them have come, we've discussed, that's why you've seen most of them reopening, resuming business, because we've had a working methodology and mechanism, how they are going to honor and settle their dues.
And now I bring in a sense of the agricultural sector, where one Dennis Majambere says Rwanda aims at ensuring food security, but how can that be achieved if the tax body levies high taxes on agriculture products?
Maybe to give you a sense of what we get from agriculture in terms of taxation. Agriculture contributes 0.1%.
Taxes?
Yes.
Okay.
In our total collection. So basically, it's almost nothing. And it's not by accident. If your turnover is 1 million a month, which you multiply by 12, you get 12 million a year, you are exempt. You're not required to pay any tax. But if you move above 12 million threshold, then you start contributing. So saying that we are taxing agriculture heavily, I don't think it's true. But also, when you look at agriculture, if you get into value addition, I think maybe that's another area of concern. For example, if you say people are preparing wheat flour, if you talk of bakalesa. Bakalesa is dealing in wheat flour. They're adding value to the wheat grains.
Mm.
So the wheat grains will not be taxed, but when the moment you start adding value, then taxation comes in. So we are very mindful of food security, and again, there's a study that is being conducted at country level to see how can we start actually taxing agriculture. But we are very mindful and very careful of how to tax agriculture. And that's why we need also to conduct that study and make very informed decisions at policy level.
Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.
And thank you so much for your questions. I never forget to thank you because you are a big part on the BQ. And to find out our next guest, please visit us on Twitter at RRTV English or on Facebook at RRTV English still.